All right, well, here we are inside of Aero. So the first thing we want to do is we want to create a new scene. So let's hit create scene, and you can name this anything you want. I'm going to call it interactive card because I'm crazy that way. Interactive card. And now once that's there, I hit return and it has created the scene. Now here we are in Aero. Now, something to remember about creating an augmented reality experience is that you really do want a beginning, middle, and end. Like, you kind of want it to wrap it up in a little bit of a story. So in our beginning, we actually have the box that is telling the user, tap on me. So we're going to start by creating a box and an arrow that says tap on me. So the first thing we want to do is we're going to come over here into the starter assets, and we're going to go to abstract shapes. And since I want to do a cube, I'm going to come down here and find Mr. Solid Cube. And I'm going to drop him in the scene. We'll leave all this as is over here. It doesn't really matter so much, but there it is. That's our cube, looking great and dandy. Now I want to have the arrow that points to it to tell the user, hey, tap on this cube. And now I created a quick arrow or pointer. I called it pointer because arrow in Aero, like pointer arrow and then augmented reality arrow. It was getting confusing for me. So I created it called pointer. Now there's two ways to bring that in. It's just a simple PNG that I created in Photoshop that you can kind of see down here in the corner. Now I could click this button here and I can go find it. I find that's a little tedious. So what I do is I just keep a window open over here and I could just grab things I could drag and drop in there. So here's pointer PNG. I'm going to grab the pointer PNG and I'm going to drop it in here, drop it in the scene, and I can move this. So there's the pointer and I'm going to, whoops, I missed it. I'll come over here to the scene list. This makes it easy to grab things. So you want to use this quite a bit. So I'm going to grab pointer and I'm going to say, okay, Mr. Pointer, you're coming up with me. And now we have the gold box and a gold pointer. We can hit preview and see what it looks like. Not very exciting, but hey, it's a start. All right, so come back to edit. We want to make this pointer bounce up and down to basically tell the user, tap on me. So let's do that. We can do it like this, tap on me, or we can come down here to the behavior builder. Now this is, behavior builder is where you add behaviors to the objects in your scene. And they're done off of triggers. So there are three types of triggers currently in Aero. We have a start trigger, and this will start the action as soon as the scene starts. We have a tap trigger, and this will start the action as soon as someone taps on that object. And we have an enter proximity, and that, since augmented reality is interactive and you can move around the scene, we have triggers that if you enter into a scene, an action will happen. So for this, we're gonna use start, because we just want it to go as soon as you start the scene. I'm going to zoom into this arrow. I can do that by, if I have it selected, by hitting F. If I don't have it selected and I want to zoom everything, I hit Shift F and it'll zoom everything, that works for me now. All right, so start, I'm going to add an action, which is going to be move. And now what move will do, I'm going to tell it to move and I'm going to go off of the Y axis and I'm going to go up about 3 meters. Now it doesn't show you here that I went up 3 meters, but if I hit play, it'll show me. See, it kind of eases in because its duration is set to 1. I want to show you something tricky too. If you're not used to 3D, you may not know which way is Y and X and Z. Well, Y is green, X is red, and Z is blue. You can also look down here. So Y is up. So I know if I move this up, it's going to go Y. Z is forward. So if I want to move forward, I'm going to go Z, and X is to the side. So that's just a little hint there. I want this to happen pretty fast. So I'm going to go to 0.5. Ease in and ease out is how the curves, the animation curves, kind of go move in and out of the position. I'm going to leave it as ease in and ease out. That's a very pleasant kind of transition. I'm not going to worry about play count or delay because I want it to go forever. So I'm going to click infinite and I want it to go back and forth. So it's going to go up and down, up and down, up and down. And now if I come into preview here, I can see what it looks like. I see it's just pointing, saying, click me, click me. This is a great indicator to the user that, hey, I need to click that box. I'm going to make it a little bigger. So let's come back over here and I'm going to make this go up maybe 4. And let's preview it again. Yeah, that's a little better, right? Same. Click, click, click. Now I'm going to add one more indicator onto the box. So I'm going to say on start, I would like you to scale just a little bit. I'm just going to have it scale just a slight amount. So I'm going to come in here. I'm going to say 1 point. Let's go 125. See what that looks like. Oh, that might be too much, but we'll see. So I'm going to keep the same thing. I keep duration as 1 second. I'm going to keep the ease in and ease out. So it's going to ease out of this pose here and it's going to ease into the next pose. And I'm going to go infinite and I'm going to go back and forth. So it kind of has like a pulsating thing. Oh, that's maybe it's too much. But so you see how you kind of want to interact with that? You want to click on it. This is a classic game design move, saying like interact with this object. You could also have it spin or do whatever you want. But I'm going to tone that down just a hair. I think it's too much. So it'll go 1.05. And let's see how that does. Yeah, that's better. Cool. So now we have the arrow saying click on me. And we have the box kind of moving up and down. So now we're ready to actually go to the second scene, right? So this is going to show the user, hey, interact with this box. And then that's the beginning. And then we're going to go to the middle of the experience next.